not that kind of wedding. They do everything for you. No, I won't be wearing a smile. Mom, I gotta run. I'm late for class. I love you. Bye.
Our most important consideration is our patients. We have with us today a young volunteer from the clinic, Mr. Lars Jensen. 11 years old, chest pains, a rash on the abdomen, and a cough. Thoughts, anyone?
Bacterial pneumonia.
But, given the rash, could be varicella.
Well, thank you for joining us, Miss Morgan. Why don't you step down here and take a look?
Yes, doctor. Hi, Lars.
Hello.
Let's see that rash. Doctor, would you mind handing me a cotton swab and some alcohol?
As you wish.
Thank you, doctor. This might be a bit cold. Ooh. Looks like we have a severe case of viral blush. Someone got into his mother's makeup.
But I do have a pain in my chest.
Really?
Yes. My heart aches for you, Paige Morgan.
Okay, wise guy. Go on. Get out of here.
I did it! I did it! I met my future queen! She's a fox!
Hey, fox lady.
Very funny.
Look, some of us are meeting back in my dorm room later to study. You want to come?
I can't tonight.
Danish lesson?
Date Edvard.
A date.
Mm-hmm.
You two are getting married in 3 weeks.
I know, but it's been so crazy lately with school and planning the wedding, and we haven't had any time alone together.
So you two made a date.
Mm-hmm. I'll see you tomorrow, all right, Jake?
All right.
Bye.
Whoops.
Soren?
I'm afraid my duties don't extend to that sort of thing.
Soren, what are you doing here? Where's Eddie?
I regret to say that Edward is tied up in Parliament, Miss Page.
Again?
I'm afraid so. He apologizes and asks for a rain check. Is that what it's called? It's Mr. Wake, that morning break down past the crew. Yes, Miss Page?
And this isn't the way to the palace?
A small detour, if you don't mind. There are some papers that need your signature. They won't take but a minute. In the East Hall, this time.
All right, son.
Attracted to you.
How did you...
I raided the entire Blue Monarch population of Europe. But you see, they wanted to come anyway.
You know, they say, if you catch a butterfly, you should whisper a wish and set it free. The butterfly carries the wish directly to the spirits.
Well, then it must work. Because my wish has already come true. Hmm.
reply from the Royal Palace with Their Majesties Rosalind and Harold, Crown Queen Page and King Edvard.
Your Majesty, is it true that the two of you were lab partners at the university?
Yes, I suppose you could say we literally had chemistry together.
And, sir, has Paige impressed you with her ability to adapt to her new role?
Definitely, yes. Taking on the responsibilities of being a queen and studying to be a doctor, I think that's very impressive.
And what's been the most challenging aspect for you, Miss Paige?
The language. I mean, Danish is a beautiful language, but it can be a challenge when you're learning. I want so badly to be fluent.
Du blir hurtig flørende.
I will be fluent in no time.
The royal wedding of King Edward and his wife-to-be, Miss Paige Morgan, is just 3 weeks away. Don't miss the live coverage here on...
Is Harold blind? This girl's nothing more than a gold-digging commoner. I wouldn't let her marry my son.
You don't have to worry about that, sir. One, you don't have a son. And two, the only gold you have to be dug is in your teeth.
I'm the third prince of Norway, once removed. I'll not have sarcasm from the likes of you.
Yes, your royal highness. And I am just your humble accountant.
So, you insist, Henrik, that my funds are currently in short supply.
Actually, I might say that you're insolvent, bankrupt, penniless.
Enough, enough. If I'd have been born one prince less removed, I'd have been very, very rich.
But that wouldn't have changed your poor betting history at the track.
Henrik, or... I didn't call you in here to discuss my past financial ventures. I called you in to show you this.
And this is...
my salvation.
What do you mean? I didn't lose you.
Oh, no, he did.
That man
is when it comes down to the blessing.
Maybe hopeless, you mean.
Your Majesty, Your Highnesses, may I bring you a drink?
Indeed you may. We absolutely crave a bottle of 83 Chateau Margaux.
Glad, what is the occasion?
The occasion is I'm thirsty.
Excuse me. I'd actually like a beer. Whatever you have on tap would be
fine. Now there is a true Dane. Yes, I'll have a beer as well.
Sure.
Edward, will you share a box at Monaco this year?
No, I can't make it this year. I've got better things to do, like run the country.
Oh, boo-hoo.
Yes, boo-hoo.
Well, then you'll miss none other than your favorite princess popping champagne and awarding the title in the champion's circle.
Carmilla, I'll be terminally bored if it's just you again.
Oh, stop it.
And you, Paige, please tell me you will make the race.
Oh, I don't think I'll be making any of the races this year. I will be in the library trying to make the grade.
I see there. There is my baby.
Gabby, perhaps instead of popping champagne in Monaco, you could pop a beer and start a new trend.
Yeah, she is right. But where is the wine? We need the wine.
You know, when I was young, I used to be terrified of this stuff. I used to think that they were all watching me and they were going to come alive and chase me.
I can't imagine why. They look so friendly.
Well, my mother used to think that it was my fear of not living up to my ancestors' expectations. I suppose there's some kind of truth in that, so they don't look terribly approving, do they?
I wonder what they'd say about us.
What would they say about us? They would say, Edward, you are a lucky bastard. And they bust a move. You get that? Bust a move. It's a joke.
Wow. My Danish is scary as whatever that just was. Wow, see, I love that. That's your happy smile.
As opposed to my unhappy smile.
No, as opposed to your trying smile, your diplomatic smile, your...
Is that supposed to be me?
Yeah. Polite, authoritative, a little flare of the nostril.
Well, it seems you know me rather well.
The florists are very pleased, and we need your approval on a centerpiece.
How about tomorrow after my biology class, say 3 o'clock?
Fine. Now, the tailors are hoping for a final fitting for your wedding dress.
I can't do it tomorrow at 9, though. I've got applied anatomy. We're dissecting a gallbladder.
Lovely. Yes, Soren.
We
Queen Rosalind, Miss Page. I'm sorry to interrupt you, but Prince Albert of Norway is in the library.
In our library? Albert, now?
Yes, Your Majesty. He came unannounced, but says he has urgent business to discuss with you. His Royal Highness and Edward are on their way there.
Thank you, Thorin. I will join them in the library. Albert and Harry went to school together.
He's a friend of yours?
Hardly. Albert's always been jealous of our family.
And then why is he here now?
Urgent business usually means he's here to borrow money.
Albert!
Your Majesty. Lovely as always. Harold.
Albert.
You remember Edward, of course.
Of course.
I remember when you were learning to play chess. How you hated to lose your queen, and now your king. Funny how that happens, isn't it?
Yes. Right.
Enough of the small talk. How much do you need this time, Albert?
Harold, you hurt my feelings. I'm not here for money. Milos, Canla, Bigus. With law shall a land be built. This is an original copy of the Jutland Code. First proclaimed in the town of Vordingborg in 1241 AD, and one of the most significant doctrines...
We're familiar medieval... with the doctrine, Albert. What is the meaning of bringing it here?
Where a son succeeds the throne unwed, he must marry a woman of noble descent and ensure the monarchy. Whereupon such a woman does exist, he shall agree to marry her. Otherwise... surrender his position as king.
Is this some sort of joke?
No joke. As it happens, my daughter, Princess Kirsten, happens to be such a woman of noble birth that this succession law applies to.
Your law is from the Middle Ages. It says archaic as chastity bells.
It's never been contested or rewritten. Therefore, according to Danish constitution, it stands.
Edward, why don't you join Paige in my quarters, and your father and I will speak to Albert alone?
This is absurd.
Sorry, sir. Didn't hear you coming.
You should work on your... eavesdropping skills, Zoran.
Yes, sir. Excuse me, sir.
Mm-hmm.
Would you like me to work on them now?
Splendid idea.
Thank you, sir.
Eddie, are you sure we shouldn't be worried?
Absolutely not. Listen, in Norway, the tabloids affectionately refer to Albert as the Royal Pain. And trust me, the title is well deserved.
And what about Kirsten? How well do you know her?
She was my best friend when we were young.
What's she like?
She's nice. Oh, you mean what does she look like? Well, to be quite honest, Kirsten was always rotund.
You're not just saying that to make me feel better.
No. Paige, listen, in 3 weeks, I'm going to marry the most captivating, beautiful girl from Wisconsin. No law, no bankrupt idiot is going to stop that from happening, okay? No.
Thorin, this is for you.
Why, thank you, Miss Page.
Thorin, what's wrong?
And what makes you think there's something wrong, sir?
You're smiling.
Well, I've just received a present.
You've had this odd expression on your face ever since you arrived. Has he not gone?
Actually, he has. He went to the airport.
Oh, well, excellent. What's the problem?
He went there to pick up his daughter, Princess Kirsten.
It just seems strange that this obscure law suddenly takes precedence.
In Denmark, we adhere to the rule of law.
Mother, this is not a law. It's a plot hatched by some dimwit.
Though this particular law is antiquated, I'm afraid it remains valid. Every move we make in the coming weeks will be of great consequence for us and for the state.
Our lawyers are the finest in the world. They will discover a solution.
The solution is I marry Paige.
Of course it is, Edward. And your father and I will do everything in our power to see that that happens. Now, Albert has agreed to keep it out of the press.
That will give us the time to find a loophole in the law.
So, what do we do until then?
We continue to prepare for the wedding. As far as anyone else is concerned, Prince Albert of Norway is on a goodwill visit with his daughter.
Does Kirsten even know that her father is plotting this scheme? Because if she did, I don't think she'd go along with this.
Edward, Paige, as king and queen, you will find many will love you, but some will seek to destroy you. No matter the crisis, we must at all times do what is right for the people.
Kirsten's arrived.
Oh, thank you so much for doing that.
Eddie? Where I come from, that is not rotund.
Edward?
Kirsten, I didn't recognize you.
Well, it has been 9 years. How are you?
I'm very well. This is Paige Morgan, my fiancée.
Paige. I have been absolutely dying to meet you, the American girl who stole Denmark's heart.
Really, the pleasure is all mine.
Do get a move on, Kirsten. They're showing us to our rooms, and I'm hungry. You can reminisce later.
Sorry. Well, Paige, let's get together later, and I will tell you every embarrassing story about Edvard that he doesn't want you to know. And you? We've got some catching up to do, haven't we?
Crash,
tired? The cutaneous nerve branches to the lateral thoracic wall are derived from the...
intercostal nerve.
Very good.
I just don't understand why he wanted to have dinner with her alone.
During development, the limb bud that forms the upper extremity rotates approximately 90 degrees in what direction?
Laterally. He said she'd be more forthcoming without me present.
Ah, yes. Yes. True or false? All cervical vertebrae have bifidospinous processes.
False. It would help if she didn't look like a supermodel.
Perhaps we should move on to your Danish lesson.
Sorry.
No need for apologies. But if you don't mind my saying, Miss Page, you have nothing to be jealous of.
I'm not jealous. Who would be jealous of a gorgeous blonde Norwegian princess?
Well, if my opinion is of any consolation, I think that, frankly, how do they say it in the States? Girl got nothing on you. Yo.
Edward, look. I just want you to know that I feel so embarrassed by my father's behavior. I mean, your poor fiancée must think I'm some evil witch trying to take her place.
No, not at all. Listen, I told her there's no way you could have been involved in this.
So she doesn't hate me?
No. Do you know, actually, I think you two would get on very well.
She seems like a great girl.
Yes.
She'd have to be, wouldn't she, to land a guy like you?
Well, that's very kind of you to say so. It's been a long time.
I know. I was remembering one of the times I came to spend the summer here. I think I was about 8 years old, so must have been...
I was about 10, yes.
I distinctly remember going up to your bedroom and asking if you wanted to play. And you turned around very seriously and said to me, Kirsten, we're no longer children, you know. You don't ask someone if they want to play. You
ask them to do something. Yeah, so good.
You were such an obnoxious brat.
Thank you.
And then again, you were the only boy who didn't make fun of me for being fat. So for that, I'm very grateful.
Well, kids can be cruel. I mean, let's face it, you were a bit of a chubster.
Excuse me, but you were not such a hottie in those days yourself. Anyway, look, I'm here to help.
I hope you know that.
Yes, I do, and I thank you. It's nice to see you again, Kirsten.
And you. Cheers.
Cheers.
Hey, Mom. It's me. I guess you're out starting your day. I'm just about to go to bed. But I just wanted to call and tell you that... everything's great. And I can't wait for you to get here. Kiss Dad for me.
Paige, I'm so glad you agreed to talk to me. My father's acting like a complete fool. I'm so sorry he's causing such drama just weeks before your wedding.
Can I ask you something?
Anything.
Why is your father even doing this if it isn't something that you want?
Because it's not about what I want. About him wanting to live vicariously through me. You know, being married to a king, a title he'll never have, that kind of stuff.
Right.
But actually, my personal theory is that he's having a midlife crisis.
My own father had one of those at 40. He got an earring.
Tragic. Mm.
Paige?
Good morning.
Oh, good morning. What's
so funny? Oh, nothing. We were just eating and I said something about toast and she thought I said toes and I guess you had to be there.
Ah, sounds hilarious.
Eddie, it was funny.
You know what, we should go.
Oh, yeah. I will be back in a little bit.
Wait, are you two going somewhere?
Kirsten's going to show me some of her favorite sights in Copenhagen.
Oh, you're going shopping.
See you later.
Yo, leave some money in the treasury.
I'm coming out tonight and I'm feeling right. Moving to the beat of the drum. Five something deep, it's kind of kick, take it, shake it, make a trip.
So cute.
Look at you.
Look at you.
Your outfit is so nice.
Thank you for having me back, Daddy.
How much longer is Kristen in town for?
I don't know. Hopefully long enough to stir things up. This fairy tale romance is getting bloody boring.
I want the best lawyers and judges in the country working around the clock on this.
My colleagues and I are confident we'll crack this case within a week.
Good. We must resolve this matter quickly and quietly. We've got a wedding to attend.
Hey, babe.
Oh, hey.
You're from the library?
Yes. Where are you off to?
Oh, I'm going into town. I need to pick something up. But I'll meet you and Edward at the restaurant later.
Great. Oh, are you going to stop back by here to change?
Probably not. This place is pretty casual. Have a nice day.
Thanks, you too.
No, that's fine. Don't worry.
Greetings, lovebird. Paige, how is it that you managed to look so smashing in everything you wear?
Kirsten, you changed.
Right, yeah, I had to. I met this dreamy guy in Old Town, but he managed to spill a drink all over me.
Well, the Rose Gallery has already assembled. Shall we wander up? For you? Hello.
Hi.
Oh, hi.
Kirsten.
Hi.
Naughty Kirsten, he's just like you.
Oh. To bounce from Denmark with no advance press, now.
Gabby, how are you? It's been so long.
You look delectable.
Well, that's the point, isn't it? But really, Kirsten, why all the hush-hush?
Hi, Paige.
Hi.
Edward, I want you 2-1 on the green this year.
No, no time for polo, Fred.
You mean no time for far?
Yes, hello? Yes, I just got to take this. One sec.
Okay. Paige, should we order you a beer?
Oh, try the wine.
Practice makes perfect.
So, tell me that.
Tell all.
You still that guy? What was his name?
The Prince from Greece?
No, not that bronze Adonis. No, the Norm.
Oh, the bartender. God, no, that was just a fling.
I remember your parents were beside themselves.
I dated Norm just before Vlad, and I began our current tryst.
You alley cat. I had no idea.
Wait, so both of you dated a guy named Norm?
Oh, no, no, that's not the case.
Norm is just a nickname.
Oh.
Yeah, for a commoner, you know, like the Norm, regular person. I mean, that didn't come out right.
We're being idiots. Paige, I'm so sorry. I didn't mean to sound like a snob. Gabby was just referring to the whole culture clash thing. You know, coming from such different worlds, sometimes it can really cause problems. But
you and Edvard don't have anything to worry about. His parents love you, Denmark loves you, and so do we.
Oh, there's Edvard.
I propose a toast to Paige of Denmark.
Ah, cheers.
Ah, cheers, cheers, everyone. Cheers.
What did I miss?
Come in.
Wait. Come back in.
Very good. Well, I was going to say come shopping, but I see you're studying, so.
Trying.
Hey, it's a difficult language. Don't give up.
I just feel like I can understand so much more than I can speak.
That's rubbish. The problem isn't you, it's what they're teaching you. I mean, trust me, I speak 7 languages. The only way to learn is to completely immerse yourself in it. Believe me, I picked up more French living in Saint-Tropez for 5 months than I did studying it for 5 years.
What else did you pick up in Saint-Tropez?
Wouldn't you like to know? No, seriously, I can help. We just need to start talking.
Well, that'll be a short conversation.
So, my dear Paige, how is your Danish coming along?
Oh, she's doing terribly well. I've been helping her with her lessons.
That's very kind of you,
Kirsten. Yes, Paige is dedicated to learning Danish quickly.
So, Paige, tell us some interesting news.
Okay, let's see. Dronning en Erluder. Honka Godley at Roger Mednumsen. Akti se Pabromster.
Well, it is a tricky language, our Danish.
Why don't we retire to the drawing room for dessert?
Splendid idea.
Did I do something wrong?
Well, you called my mother a donkey. A green donkey, in fact.
No, I said she had a green thumb and that she waves her hand and flowers grow, you know, because of her orchids. I don't even know the word for donkey.
Oh, you do. You do. But you know what? It's great pronunciation.
Good morning, Copenhagen. Here's the latest from the States, the hot new single from The Drop.
Waking up, and now I'm gone. I can hear what
right
you
say. Song.
Yeah, I'm not for me.
I love this song.
It's just a game I can't stop. Anyway, I have a little surprise for you. A little goodie.
Oh, wow. Wow, it's the dress I tried on in the store.
Yeah, I could see how much you liked it, so I couldn't resist.
I can wear it to the shower today.
Hey, that's a great idea.
Thank you, Kirsten. Yeah, that was nice.
It's my pleasure.
At last, our guest of honor.
It looks beautiful.
A beautiful luncheon for a beautiful bride.
I really appreciate you doing that.
Not at all. And you look marvelous. What a lovely outfit.
Thank you.
Paige, are you all right?
Yeah, I'm all right. Just a little itch.
Well, come.
What beautiful sculptures.
Thank you. They're Bernini's, 17th century. We just got them at Sotheby's. Aren't they fabulous? Lovely.
Do you feel itchy?
Itchy?
Yeah. I thought maybe there was something in the air.
Afternoon, ladies.
Edward, perfect timing. Paige is just about to open gifts.
Oh, perhaps I should come back tomorrow.
Okay, I will go ahead and start with this one. It's from Vivian.
Paige, what are you doing?
I don't know. I'm just so itchy.
Well, I am going to open that one. Let's see, we've got a card here. Paige, we've got a card. Paige and Edward. To a life. To a life filled with love, life, love and happiness. And Greta. Greta, thank you. Yes, well. Let's see what's in here. Oh, tongs. Tongs, Paige. We were just talking about tongs yesterday, and how much we need them. Let's open the other one. This one. Every prezi. Look at this.
Oh.
Ooh. I think she was taken with the tongs.
Paige? What's happened? Are you all right?
Yeah, I'm fine. No, I don't know. I'm so embarrassed. It feels like there's ants crawling all over my body.
You just had a reaction to something.
Can you just calm down?
Paige, are you okay? Is there anything I can do to help? No, I think you've done enough, Kirsten.
Just...
Paige, wait.
You think Kirsten had something to do with it?
I just feel like the more Kirsten acts like my friend, the more things happen to go wrong.
Look. You are under a lot of pressure right now. You've got Kirsten and her family staying here. Albert, who doesn't seem to like you. You have your studies. But I think you're confusing father and daughter and, quite frankly, acting a bit paranoid. I know Kirsten. She would never do the things you're accusing her of doing. Come on, just go and talk to her. You two can work this out. For me? For me?
Kirsten?
There you are.
I've been looking for you.
Wow, Kirsten. You scared me.
Paige, what are you doing in my room?
Well, I was coming by to apologize. But then I found this. You almost had me.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Oh, come on, Kirsten. I know what this is. Urushiol resin is what they find in poison ivy that causes an allergic reaction in the skin.
I'm just a guest here, Paige. That could very easily belong to the person who stayed in this room before me.
Right. So the Duke of Windsor's out there somewhere missing his after-shower itching powder.
May I see?
Mm.
You know, I knew that powder was going to work, but I didn't realize it was going to work quite so well. I mean, the Bernini statue into the cake? Paige, that was priceless.
I can't believe I actually envied you.
Oh, don't feel bad. It's only natural that you would. I mean, you're a sweet girl, Paige, but let's face it, you're a little out of your league here. It's not your fault. You got swept up in a fairy tale. I understand. But you see, the problem is, Eddie was never meant to marry someone who was born to milk cows.
Edvard and I are getting married in a week. Don't you know to give up when the game is already lost?
There is no game, Paige. There are only royals and norms. And I'm afraid they just don't go together. No matter how hard they might try.
Does Edvard know you feel this way? He might find it very interesting.
Oh, go ahead. Tell Edvard anything you like. Please, I dare you. Eddie and I have known each other all our lives. It will just end up an ugly little case of my word against yours. So, by all means, make more trouble for yourself. Give Eddie yet another reason to feel that marrying you is just one big mistake.
Hello? Ah. Sir. You two sorted things out?
We're fine. It was just a little misunderstanding.
Good. Because the last thing I need right now is my oldest, dearest friend and my fiancé at odds with one another. I'll be downstairs.
I wanted to tell him, but I just couldn't. I mean, he seemed so relieved that everything was okay.
So what? Are you afraid you're going to disappoint him?
Afraid? No, I mean, what difference is it going to make? It's not going to change the law. It's not going to help find the loophole. It's only going to put more pressure on Eddie. I'm just going to have to deal with this on my own.
Well, what are you going to do?
Beat her at her own game.
It's an honor for me to be here today, and I would especially like to thank the Copenhagen Historical Society for making this event possible. For decades, this ship proudly served our nation's greatest industry, and today we're here to celebrate the commencement of the restoration of King Clupea.
That's your diplomatic. I'm sorry Edvard couldn't stay for lunch, Mr. Christensen.
Oh, I fully understand.
Thank you so much for including my father and me in this celebration.
Oh, we are honored to have you here, Mrs. Kirsten.
Thank you.
I love the name of the ship. Isn't Clupea the scientific name for herring?
Why, yes, it is. Miss Page, most people don't know that.
Hmm.
I was reading the other day about how Margaret, first of Denmark, had to battle Norway for Scandinavian supremacy. She ran naval gauntlets to keep the city supplied with food.
She wouldn't have had to go to such extremes, of course, if she'd had the support of local fishermen.
Actually, Kirsten, I believe you're mistaken. Margaret was revered by the local fishermen. They felt she was the only one who could identify with their needs.
Or perhaps it was because she was a true royal. The commoners knew that she was qualified to lead them.
In any case, she issued a royal warrant giving the Norwegians 1 week to vacate Denmark.
Indeed she did. Miss Page, I must say, I'm impressed with your breadth of knowledge. You have truly embraced Denmark as your country. So, shall we start?
Absolutely. This looks fabulous. Paige, I imagine you're excited to dine on the national delicacy. Lumpfish caviar.
Oh, lumpfish.
Madam, you may want the caviar not with the silver fork, but with the caviar straw. It wasn't the metal to ruin the taste.
Oh.
We're having caviar again tonight, Paige. Don't forget your fork.
We all extend our heartfelt thanks to Crown Queen Paige for her generous sponsorship of today's Great Masters charity event. Crown Queen Paige.
Thank you, Mrs. Lawrenson. You, my friends, are gathered here today to support a cause that is near and dear to my heart, to all our hearts. The donations made today will provide medicine to the world's neediest. And now I would like to introduce from Rome, piano maestro Michael Illestroni, who has agreed to entertain us today with excerpts from The Magic Flute. Maestro Illestroni.
She gasped and passed out.
Has this happened before?
No.
Any conditions? Diseases? No. Asthma? Epilepsy? Benta? Benta, can you hear me? Benta, wake up. Oh, there you go. Benta, you passed out. Everything's fine. Are you okay?
Oh, I think so.
Try to sit up. Your chest wall is constrained.
Oh. It appears to be a fainting spell.
Yes, the singing was too much for her.
Ladies. Right, here we go. One for you. One for you.
Thank you very much.
One for me. Thank you. Cheers.
Cheers.
Listen, duty calls. One sec.
Maybe they can play Madame Butterfly and you can sing.
Or maybe they can fiddle Someday My Prince Will Come and you can dream on.
Ladies and gentlemen. Ladies and gentlemen, could I have your attention, please? I'd like to invite King Edvard and Crown Queen Paige onto the dance floor to lead us in the Schnurrbacken.
Actually,
Actually, I would like to give my dance to Princess Kirsten, as I am confident she does a finer snurrbookin' than I.
No, Paige.
No, really, I insist.
Go on.
I love to watch you dance.
You ready? Okay.
You right?
Okay. 5, 6, 7, 8. You right? Oh dear. Should I? Is she all right?
I think so.
All right, fine. Right. So how did you get so good at this?
The poker room is fancier.
Yeah.
Tonight was a disaster. How dare that little wannabe try and make a fool out of me?
Well, Kirsten, I let you do it your way. Now I'm out of patience and funds. This little charade is over. You wanted to see me?
It's all over the paper.
Oh, dear. How did this happen?
That's what we'd like to know.
Well, you don't think it was me. Why would I risk alienating the entire country of Denmark just days before the wedding? This is a delicate matter. And I gave you my word. I'm a man of my word.
It's time we turned the crude instrument of the media to our own advantage.
A press conference, when?
Tomorrow at 2:30.
I've got class at 1.
Paige, look, this is really, really important.
I guess I could leave early.
Are you sure?
Yeah, shouldn't be a problem.
Okay, well, look, I'll get Zoran to pick you up at 2 o'clock. Okay, you got that, 2 o'clock. Thank you.
But of course, we must remember, when comparing one antibody to another, that these amino acid sequences are quite distinct.
Shoot.
Now, let's turn to a related problem, and that's toxicity in blood transfusions.
I know.
Be here any moment.
What's going on?
It's an accident, I believe.
We can't wait any longer. Finally.
King Edvard, can you tell us your reaction when you first heard about the succession rule?
Well, disappointment at first and surprise, but we need to have the flexibility to re-examine archaic rules of this nature.
Your Majesty, is it meaningful that Miss Page is not here with you today?
She...
But I'm here! Sorry, mate.
Just one question at a time, please.
Paige, you intend to go ahead with the marriage?
Of course. The succession law does not change my feelings for Edvard.
Are you concerned about the reaction of the Danish people to the news?
Well, I've come to believe that the Danish people are among the most kind and forward-thinking people on this planet. I trust their reaction will be supportive and understanding.
King Edward, would you be willing to abdicate the throne to marry Paige?
Sir, that is a thoughtless question.
But, Your Majesty, if no legal solution can be found, would you relinquish the monarchy in order to marry Paige Morgan?
Sir, once again, I'm confident that will not happen.
Miss Page, would you ask King Edward to abandon the crown in order to marry you?
She...
In my country, we aren't bound by such unusual customs. We're free to marry whomever we love.
Crown Queen Page, do you not consider Denmark to be your country?
But this is not at all what I meant.
My dear Paige, there are certain things that the Danish people take very seriously. Fighting their monarchy is one of them.
But I love Denmark, and I love all of you. This was taken completely out of context.
The press does not know the meaning of context. They care about one thing, selling papers. I should know that by now.
I give mine 12 hours a day.
Oh, I'll have to try that. And these phalaenopsis are just gorgeous. You really do have a way with flowers.
Thank you.
Personal
hobby.
Paige. Oh, I've been looking for you everywhere.
Actually, I was looking for you too.
Hey. You okay?
Yeah, fine. I wanted to talk to you about tonight.
Yes, precisely what I want to talk to you about. Look, I've got a meeting at 6 o'clock, and then after, I thought you and I could go for a meal somewhere, just the two of us.
I was going to ask you if maybe we could eat early because I have a study group and it's probably going to go late.
Right, okay.
It's just that exams are...
Yes, I know, in 2 weeks. Okay, but I could reschedule and then...
Well, no, I wouldn't want you to do that. It's too important.
No, you're right. Okay,
well, fine. Eddie, if you'd prefer...
No, it's fine. It's fine.
You sure?
Yes. Yes, it's fine.
Hi, Paige.
Don't forget this.
You're
going to
want
that.
Bye.
Bye, guys.
Thank you.
So, how do you feel?
Well, I feel a little shaky on immunoglobulins, but other than that...
No, I'm not talking about the exam, Paige. I'm talking about the tabloids and the stuff with Kirsten.
I don't know. I want nothing more in the world than to marry Edward. But all this stuff with Kirsten and the tabloids...
It's gonna be all right.
Are you sure?
Paige, you are an amazing girl. And you are going to make an incredible doctor.
But will I make a good queen?
Yes. Denmark is lucky to have you.
Thank you, Jake. I appreciate your dishonesty.
It's the truth. Come here.
Gotcha. But you went there to study.
I did. We were. Eddie, this is ridiculous.
Is it? I mean, you two look awfully comfortable.
Jake is my friend. After everyone left, we were talking. I was telling him about everything we'd been through, everything we had to deal with, and so he hugged me. That was it.
I see.
What? What?
Nothing.
Eddie, come on. You don't actually think that after everything I've been through, I'm so tired of having to defend myself against these stupid tabloids.
Well, the point is you shouldn't have to.
Exactly.
No. You're not hearing me. You shouldn't even allow yourself to be put in any situation remotely compromising. It's time you start acting less like,
Like a what?
And what exactly have you been through?
Like a what, Eddie? Like a norm?
Paige, for better or for worse, things are done differently around here.
I know.
And when you allow your actions to be misinterpreted in any way at all, you affect much more than yourself.
Like you, right?
Right, I didn't say that, but yes, like me. Like my family, like the entire monarchy. Do you know the risk I've taken with you? I mean, do you think... Do you think this has been easy on me?
Easy on you. Maybe Kirsten's right.
Right about what?
Oh, come on, Eddie. I may not think like a royal, but I'm far from stupid. And contrary to what you may think, I am not paranoid.
Well, what are you talking about? What?
Whether you choose to see it or not, Kirsten has been trying to come between us from the moment she arrived. And the funny thing is, I'm starting to think she's right. Maybe she does belong here more than I do.
No, Paige, look, I don't feel that way. I don't feel that way about her.
Maybe you don't think you do. But inside you can feel something's wrong. Kirsten coming, the loophole, the tabloids. Maybe it's all just a sign.
Paige.
No, Paige. When that reporter asked you how you felt about abdicating the throne, your only answer was that it wouldn't come to that. What if it does? Are you really prepared to give this all up? I suddenly feel very embarrassed.
Paige, listen.
You know, I started to believe in fairy tales.
What are you doing?
I'm sorry, Eddie.
Yes.
Hi. May I come in? Edvard, I heard what happened. And I'm so sorry.
know how hard this must be for you. I just somehow feel it's all my fault.
Yes, well, blaming yourself won't help.
I know, and I'm sorry. I don't mean to make this about me. I just feel bad.
You know, I was thinking that maybe this was impossible from the start.
Well, our world is so very different from most people's.
Yeah.
You know, Edvard, we've known each other all our lives. I never would have predicted we'd be in this situation. I honestly thought my father was crazy. But the truth is, the more I'm here, the more it makes me wonder.
Wonder what?
Eddie. Maybe no one's found a loophole because a loophole isn't meant to be found. You have to marry before your 23rd birthday, which is only 3 days after your wedding day. The day that you're bound by Danish law to take a Scandinavian princess as your bride. Maybe that's no coincidence. Maybe that's fate. Bringing us together.
Good God. Miss Page, this is silly. I think you should come back to the palace.
I can't.
Why not?
You know the answer to that, Soren. Besides, I'm only here until exams are over and then, I guess, back to the States.
Miss Page, you know, in my youth, I was a footballer. Excuse me, a soccer player. In one of the best junior leagues in Denmark. It may be hard to believe looking at me now, but I was rather good. One of the top players in the country for my age, actually. The year I turned 16, I played in a championship game that drew scouts from all over Europe. Suddenly there were expectations and pressures I never knew existed. In any event, I spent the whole game trying to impress the scouts, and in doing so, I ended up trying too hard. As a result, I played the worst game of my life. You see, Miss Page, I had forgotten why I was there in the first place.
Why were you there?
Because I loved the game. Always did. Goodbye, Miss Page.
Bye, Soren.
I'm sorry, Edward. I know how difficult this must be for you. But we must protect the monarchy.
So what are you saying? Are you saying that I should marry Kirsten?
I'm saying that sometimes we have to do what's best for the people, not what's best for ourselves.
Spending all my time wondering if you'll make me as happy as I say, wasting all my on you, on you, on you.
Mom. I'm okay. I'm calling to tell you. Well, it's about the wedding. Do you think it's too late for you to get a refund for your plane ticket?
Soren, I've made a decision.
I don't suppose it involves slowing down.
Well, speed helps me think, you know that.
Have you tried meditation? The same clarity, less potential loss of life.
I've decided to go through with the marriage.
To Princess Kirsten?
Well, I've given a little thought to what she said about fate, and I think she's onto something.
But, sir...
No, no buts. I'm king. It's about time I start acting like it.
Love her.
What?
The way he's looking at her. It's his diplomatic smile. It's not his smile. Look.
It's okay. I take your word for it.
I have to find a loophole, but I don't know where to look.
I might.
What? Where?
Well, the repository of ancient documents.
Which is?
Which is housed right here on campus. In the law building.
Hurry, Jake. The wedding is tomorrow.
Paige, wait. We need help.
Now, look, my law school friends are a little weird, but the thing is, nobody cares about these books except for them.
Where is the repository? Up here?
You're standing on it. It's in the catacombs. Too far, I hope.
Wow.
We are closed now.
Jake, what time is it?
Nearly 8.
You've got 14 hours to find that loophole.
And 14,000 books to look through.
I thought organic chemistry was hard.
Don't worry. Eric will tell us what to look for.
I'll write the words for you.
It's morning here in Denmark as we report live from Copenhagen's Grand Cathedral. An estimated 50,000 will line the streets this afternoon at 1 o'clock to witness the royal wedding cortege of King Edward and Princess Kirsten.
Jake, we're never gonna find
Yes, we will. We've got 2 hours.
Eric, I think I might have something. Look.
Don't give up.
I've got no choice. Paige, there's so much I need to say to you. I know I upset you when I said being with you was a risk. But the truth is, nothing is really worthwhile in life unless you do take a risk. That's why I took the risk with continuing the wedding with Kirsten. I thought it would provide me with the cover I need to find a loophole in the law. But unfortunately, we failed.
Eddie, I...
So, you know, if this means that I have to give up the throne, then so be it. I love you, Paige Morgan.
I love you, and I cannot spend my life without you.
I'm sorry, Eddie. I can't let you give up the throne. Which is why you'll need this.
You found it.
Yep, the loophole.
How on earth did she?
Oh, I love you. Oh. Hold on. We've got to go. We've got to go. Thank you. Thank you.
Thorin, I need your help.
Yes, sir. Very good, sir.
Absolutely lovely, Miss Kirsten. Just a little tense. Have some tea.
No, I don't want tea.
It'll help with your nerves.
I'm not nervous.
Just a sip.
I don't! Look what you've done!
I am in great distress, madam. Allow me to help you clear that up.
No, you're making it worse! Stop it, you idiot!
Hold on, you have to recite the entire constitution.
I don't have to memorize it. I just have to read it before Parliament. in Danish.
Oh. Yeah. You better get started.
Excuse me, Soren.
I'm sorry, sir. Miss Kirsten asked not to be disturbed.
Is something wrong?
No, no, she's perfectly fine. She just wanted some time alone.
Oh.
You know how young ladies are in these situations. In fact, she wanted me to tell you to meet her at the church. She wanted it to be a surprise. I believe there's free food in the limo.
Well, tell her to hurry up, would you?
This is impossible.
Look, you'll be fine. You can do this, okay?
Page, we have precisely 10 minutes to turn you into a queen.
Come on, everyone. Let's give the princess some privacy.
Oh, wait! I'm ready to go now.
Yes, Miss Kirsten. I'll be back in a jiffy. They're asking for you in the stables. I think it's some kind of emergency. You better go.
Thank you, sir.
What? You have a smudge.
Well,
just here on the back of your jacket. It looks like liverwurst.
Liverwurst?
Oh, you're rubbing it in, sir. May I suggest the men's room?
Good
water
idea.
Should do the trick.
Let me know the moment that Kirsten arrives.
Yes, sir. Everything sorted? Yes, sir.
Ladies and gentlemen, may I have your attention? There's been a change of plan.
You can't do this! What's she doing here?
As I was saying, there's been a change of plan.
The law says...
The law? The law? According to the first Danish constitution... was written in Vordingborg in 1282. This is 41 years after the Jutland Code was created there, making it more current and binding. It states, that, as long as a prospective heir of common descent can demonstrate knowledge of the Danish constitution in Danish, before Parliament, the succession law is null and void. And since we have the Parliament here today for the wedding, there's no better time for Paige to perform the task.
Dine Gronlov Gela for Hile de Danske Reis. The Constitution applies to all parts of the Kingdom of Denmark. Regerings for. Ringers. Riga Ings form, Atlanscribe ut Monarchy. The form of government shall be that of a constitutional monarchy.
Where are all the cars? Why won't anybody talk to me?
Kunig nu us maten till min a. Erden grund lav. And if the bill receives the royal assent, it shall form an integral part of the Constitutional Act.
Soren called?
Oh,
ancestor to ancestor, dynasty to dynasty. For 5,000 years, the crown has been the birthright of the king and queen of Denmark. But today's ceremony marks a new era in the tradition of succession. The path here has been rocky and fraught with uncertainty. Yet bravery has yielded joy, and as our king has opened his heart, so does a nation. By your solemn vow, King Edward, do you grant that a crown queen page your whole heart and your everlasting love, till death shall finally part you.
I do.
By your solemn vow, Crown Queen Paige, do you grant unto King Edvard your whole heart and your everlasting love, until death shall finally part you?
I do.
Then by this right, for God and Denmark, I declare you to be husband and wife, king and queen. You may now seal this eternal bond with a kiss.
Fairy tale, but it's really close.